Hello and welcome to Red Stapler channel. In this video, we are going to show you how to create a 3D surface chart with just JavaScript using Plotly.js, an open source JavaScript graphing library that is built on top of D3.js and very powerful for making graph and charts. It is the same library that I've shown you how to create a real-time updating chart in previous tutorial. Ready? Let's check it out. So, as usual, if you are not using NPM, we will download the latest version of Plotly.js from GitHub and include it to your page using script tag. And also create a div element that you want to display the chart. To create a surface chart, you will need to provide the data in array of arrays format like this one. You can retrieve the data from third-party API or read it from CSV file or using your database, but eventually you will need to convert it into array of array before passing to the library. So in the first example, I am going to write a function to create an array of arrays with random data with the size of 10. And the second example, I am going to read the data from the CSV file. Here's how the array looks like if we display it on console. Now we'll call plotly.newplot and pass the chart div element, followed by data and chart definition object. You can provide the data by passing the array into Z property. And set the type to surface. And that's it. Let's see how it works. Now in real life scenario, we wouldn't use the random value like this. With Plotly, you can read the CSV file to retrieve the data by using plotly.d3.csv function. The CSV data need to be in this format, with the first row and column having x and y values. You can pass the URL or path to your CSV file, followed by the callback function when the CSV was loaded. The first parameter is the error, if there is any, and the second one is the rows object from the CSV file. Let's display it on console to see how it looks like. Now you will see that we have the value of each row, but it's in object format. We need to convert it into array before we can pass it to Plotly. You can do that easily by using map method. Now let's display it to console again. Now we have the data in the correct format. The final step is to create the chart. This is only the basic, and there are lots of options to customize your chart. You can visit Plotly documentation and try experiment it. So that's it. You can find the source code at the video description box below. Please like or subscribe to stay tuned with us for more interesting tutorials. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.